So the final step in the Tomasulo's algorithm is this write result step of our broadcast. So let's see what happens during that step. So let's say that we have this situation where we have already issued some instructions. This one has been dispatched and is executing. And now is the cycle when this instruction is done and wants to broadcast its result. So what's going to happen? So the first thing that will happen is we put the tag, in this case RS1, and the result, in this case -0.29, on the bus, so it gets broadcast to all of these structures. So as a result of the broadcast, this will reach to all of these units. Now, what we want to do is write to the register file, basically. This is a new value for whichever register this ad is supposed to be writing to. And we don't have to carry that this is going to register F2, because reservation station 1 matches F2, so we know that the value is going to F2. So we're going to overwrite the value in F2 with that. So pretty much the first step is to kind of overwrite the value in the register file. So we have changed the F2 now because of this match between the RAT and the RS1. We know that F2 should be written with this value. The next thing that happens is we update the register allocation table. Basically, the entry that matches our tag needs to be changed so that it now points to the register file. We said that an empty RAT entry will be indicative of just going to the register instead of waiting for something. So now we need to basically, you know, tag this in a way that makes it empty. Usually there is a valid bit here that just says it's empty. And the last thing we need to do is free the reservation station. That is, the reservation station whose name matches is now marked as empty so that it can accept a new instruction. In this case, we kind of just delete stuff from it, but in real hardware, there would be a valid bit here that says that this is an empty reservation station. So this is what needs to happen.